Hello, hello. Good morning. Okay, Susan, are you on here? Yay! Good morning, good morning. All right, let me make sure my team's on here and everything's good. Good morning, Beth. Good morning, Christy. Good morning, Tina. Let me tag my team, make sure we're all good. I'm glad the unicorn is still there, right? I just was thinking this morning about how excited I am about what the new background's gonna be at the new house. I don't know, I barely even know what my new house looks like. I saw it one time when we were down there searching. So I'm pretty excited about that. Okay, still not seeing Susan on here. Let me just tag her real quick. Team ACA, where are you at? We're live. There she is. Okay, cool. She's sharing this. She was already doing all the stuff. Thank you, Susan. Yay! I'm really excited about today. So first I want to do just like a little mini recap of yesterday, and then we're going into today. So I have gotten so much feedback from everyone. You guys, I love you so much. And thank you so much for sharing the story. I know oftentimes we feel like, oh, like they won't care, or like this isn't significant enough or something like that. But not my girls. They know that their story is important and valuable, and they shared it with me. And I got so many messages about how Guru Sue rocks. Hell yes, she does. that was awesome, Christy. And so many women are reaching out and just sharing that the stuff is life-changing for them. It was for me too, right? Like, nobody taught us this shit. And when you start learning, when you start seeing it for what it is, it does change your life, and it changes your life fast, right? So thank you for the messages and the comments and sharing with me and letting me part of your journey and us doing it together. It's so incredible. Feel free to also, as we move forward for today and tomorrow, to share any other huge wins or breakthroughs or aha moments that you've had. And it also helps me, right? So obviously I'm a teacher. So when I am learning, thanks for the heart showers. I love them. Thanks, Amy. Distracted by the love heart showers. When you guys share your big wins with me or your breakthroughs or the ha-has you have, it helps me be like, oh, okay, this is how they were thinking, this is how they were tracking, that's how they put those pieces together, and it helps me fine-tune my teaching. Because it's really one thing to know, Kathleen, I missed it last night, watched the replay. Yeah, it was pretty awesome, so you're definitely gonna want to catch that. Just make sure you're signed up at mandyperry.com and you'll get the replays. It's one thing to know how to do it in your own life. It's a whole nother thing to teach it, right? So, and that's true for us and like the coaches I have on here or the entrepreneurs that I have on here. It's completely true. The same thing, right? It's like the same thing is exactly true in our own life. Like, yeah, we can go through this transformation. We can figure it out ourselves. But then to learn how to fine tune it and create that process for our clients, it's a different skill. And it's really friggin' fun to learn that skill. It is so much friggin' fun. Good morning, Diana. What did I just miss? Okay, so this is how I would like to begin this morning. I would like to begin by you guys. I saw a peer of mine, Amanda, do this, and I really liked it. I've never done it before. I would love to see, I think it tells you so much in such a short amount of time. I would love to see one emoji for how you're feeling right now, and then choose a second emoji for how you'd like to feel at the end of this 3-day training. And completely fucking moving forward, staying in that energy, staying in that place, like this is what I'm choosing, this is what I'm going forward to. All right, so as you guys drop those emojis in there, and if this is your first time jumping on, if you weren't here on day one, tell me where you're from. Like, we had people from all over the place, UK, Australia, Canada, a lot of people from California. I usually get a lot of the East Coast, West Coast, I'm East Coast. I always fuck that up. I have to look at the map and we's on this side and I'm on this side, so it's WE, so that's West Coast. Isn't that funny? Maryland. Okay, so as we're doing this, I'm going to recap yesterday. So yesterday what we talked about was really the idea that we have to face ourselves. Like, stop fucking around. Stop pretending we don't know what to do. Stop pretending that we are actually doing the thing that's going to move the dial in our life and get us to that next level, whatever area of your life you want to. And actually, oh, I love these. I love Amy's. Oh, Kathleen, I'm thinking you're going from, like, terrified to awe. Colorado, yay! Right, so we talked about just coming face to face with yourself and just owning your shit and just like letting it be information instead of self-criticism and judgment, right? So there is little roadies, nothing just about that shit. Holla, Rhode Island. Right, so coming face to face with yourself, owning your shit, like letting yourself just for 1 second be like, okay, so this is what it really is, right? Like, so for me, I'm just gonna be completely transparent and vulnerable. Oh, Massachusetts, that's where I grew up. Not in Raynham, but I grew up in Mass. So in my life, right? Like, so yesterday I also talked a tiny bit about my journey, right? So what you don't know is that when I made my first investment in myself, that doesn't have to necessarily always be financial. In the entrepreneur world, it kind of turns out that way. Oh, Indiana, right? In the entrepreneur world, it turns out that way most of the time because you're investing with people who are crushing it and you're wanting to learn from them, right? But it also means an investment of your time, of your mental energy, of your emotion, of the fact that you're going to get away from the scrambling and into taking fucking power moves so you can have the life that you want, right? So like, it's an investment of any kind that we're talking about. But when I made my very first investment in myself, when I said, like, I was in the nursing program, I quit. I went to the neuroscience, I quit. I was about to do, like, get into the, I was, like, next move was, like, you know, registering for the PhD program. And I quit and blew out of there, right? And, like, why would I blow out of there? Top of my class, in the neuroscience program, like, I got all these kudos from all the people around me, like, oh, my God, you're in the neuroscience program, right? And yet I was just, like, this is so stupid. Like everything that they're doing, it's like everything that they're doing is basically to come up with ideas for the next drug. And like, I just couldn't even tell you how much I didn't believe that. Of course, there's a million different fields in the neuroscience, but what I was looking at in the college I was at, that's basically like making something really complicated and big, super small and like overgeneralizing. But in being allowed to do that, it was basically jumping in on drug pushing, which I wasn't on board with. So I had the balls to leave, right? And so I had the balls to leave and then choose something different for myself and opt into a different life. But that requires knowing what the fuck you want, right? There is music. Oh yeah, can you hear the music in the background? I should probably monitor what songs are playing. There is a little bit of music. I do have some naughty songs on there. Quite a few actually, which I didn't used to give myself permission for, but now I do. Right, so I gave myself permission to have the balls to be like, no, I actually am not in alignment with that. Now, how do you think it would have worked out if I had stayed in that? I would have gotten tons of kudos from the people around me and I would have stayed in it. But then on the other side of that, I would have been like, wow, like I'm doing something and I'm getting paid well and I get kudos from everybody in my life, but my soul is like dying and soul like horrible death. Because I actually don't believe in what I'm doing. I actually think that this is a waste of time, a waste of resource. And it's actually communicating all the wrong things to the world, right? And so like, you get to have the balls to be clear about who you are and what you want. Like, what is it do you want, right? So we covered that yesterday. What the fuck do you want? Not what you should want, not what someone else told you you want, not what like the culture and society says that you need to want. Just like you Amy, you Elise, right? You Christina, what the fuck do you want? What do you actually want? What's in alignment with you? What feels good? What feels right? Who do you envision yourself to be? Right? Like, who is it that you envision yourself? Because you know she's in there. You know you're capable of it. You know that you're like 90 seconds away. And I'll get into that in a little bit. Like 90 seconds you've been away from having everything that you fucking want in your life, right? I'm going to watch the comments on here because it's so much easier for me. But I am paying attention to you. I'm just actually watching your comments on my computer because it's easier for me to read. Yes, I so agree. I'm so glad you left, right? And then we talked about how to actually take your first steps doing that. So if you missed that, I'm not going to cover all that in this training because I want to give you guys so much more value and I only get 3 days with you. So just make sure you go and watch video one if you haven't signed up, mandyperry.com, and you'll get the replay of that, right? Okay. Hi, Tracy. So anyone on here, I would love anyone here who's here yesterday, my A players, what were your ahas? This is really important. We went into the phase where at the end we claimed what the fuck we're actually going to step into, and like leaving the rest of them, like, not I will get there, not I'll do it tomorrow, not when I get there, not someday I'm going to, none of that bullshit, because tomorrow never comes. It never fucking comes. You and I both know it, right? But we're saying, like, today, right now, like, literally, I was 4 seconds ago, I was the woman who was like not following through with this and not stepping into it and not owning it and not 100% in. I'm backing myself in my fucking dreams. But as of this moment, I'm no longer that woman because I have right now shifted. I'm done. I have already shifted, right? And then we talked about making a decision, and a decision isn't made unless you're backing it. So that excited, emotional thing that we get isn't a fucking decision. It's an emotion. It feels good. It's great. We love doing it, right? I've heard it referred to as aha addiction. Like, oh, I had these ahas, and we get addicted to the aha without fucking implementing the thing that we had the aha about. So we're not about that life. We're all about the ahas and then the fucking implementation, making a decision and acting on it. So one, I would love to see, not blaming others, I'd love to see any ahas you had in that, like, that light bulb moment or the thing that sort of went in and you felt it like go all the way in. And I'd also love to hear and give so much massive credit. I know there's one woman who reached out to me, so obviously I knew that she took action. So I'll give her major props. She knows who she is. And anyone else, did you make a decision? Which means, did you fucking take some action last night, between last night and this morning? Have you taken action? Because time will just continue to pass, right? Like, it was last night, it's now morning, the day's gonna pass, the weekend's gonna pass. Don't fucking wait till Monday. What the fuck is Monday? Right? Monday can be my day off if that's what I choose. It's just a day. Like, this is your fucking life, and we're gonna do this shit now. So I just wanna give credit and call out to anyone who's had an aha, and then major props to anyone who's taken action, backed up their fucking decision, didn't let it just be an emotion, but they fucking turned it into something. She controls the music. What did I miss? Not blaming others. Hell yeah. Owning what you want. Yes. Right? Because remember, the reason you want it was because it's part of your purpose. It's part of what you're meant to do in this world. It's part of who you fucking are. Right? So yes, owning your fucking purpose, because it's who you are, right? And so if you're denying it, it's just like you're denying your body and you're denying yourself. So what's the fucking point of that, right? What's the fucking point of denying who you are? It's a lie. It's a complete lie. So every time you pretend that you don't love what you love, or you don't want what you want, you're just living in falsehood. You're living in lies. It's just bullshit. It's not true, right? Like, for me to pretend, that's something I talked about. For me to pretend, oh yeah, I was going to share that thing with you guys. I'll share it with you now. For me to pretend that I love being home Monday through Friday every night, cooking dinner and just sitting home with my kids, is just a lie. So culture and society makes me feel like I'm supposed to like that, and like I'm a bad mom if I don't like it, but I don't fucking like it. I like being home some nights with my kids, and I love going out on the weekends, and I love doing adventures, and I love being tuned into their life and like having that soul connection with them, but I don't like sitting home every single weeknight sitting around with my kids. So what the fuck is the point of me pretending that I do? Who is that serving, and how is that helping people? It's not fucking helping anyone. I spoke up for myself last night. That is one of the hardest ones. Investing in ourselves and taking that action and speaking up for ourselves. That's huge. Way to go, Dana. My aha, putting more passion into my Facebook lives, making people feel alive through my passion for my healing, taking action this afternoon when the seminar ends. Yes, Chuck. Hell yes. Backing you up, brother. Awesome. Way to go. Hell yes. My girls in the Facebook Lives training that I just had, just to give you guys an idea of how powerful it is, right? Like, I consistently continue to just keep getting messages from them, and they're posting in the group. I just booked another call. I just booked another client. I just got another client, right? All just from shifting in their Facebook Lives. So it's really powerful. That's why I did that group, right? Diana, that's where I have arrived. Exactly what I asked for, so really owning it. Showing up in these live calls is step one of the commitment to do this now. Thank you. Hell yes! Woo! I had an aha about who I want to serve, but I did not take action other than journal about it and understand my why. Yeah. So now you just get to ask yourself, like, that's it. It's cool. Like, we don't have to go at a slow pace. Like, the pendulum, like, there's really this consistent belief that the pendulum has to go, like, forward and then backwards and then forward. And, like, we take one step and then we have to, like, stall out. Or I used to have this belief that every time I up-leveled my business, I would get sick. And I just busted through that. I just busted through that. It's complete bullshit. The pendulum literally can just continue to swing forward and you can take massive, massive action. Meaning like the second you have an aha, you can turn around, shift, and then take massive action on it as though that's who you always were and it was never anything different. You get to just fucking do that if you want to. If that feels good and inviting and exciting, you get to just do that. It's not being a fraud. It's not being false. It's the fact that you're owning the fact that I just shifted. I was her. I'm no longer her. I get to now take massive action based on who I choose to be right now in this fucking second. Right? There doesn't have to be a pause or like time that passes of proving yourself. Fuck that shit. Right? Nope. Right? So this reminds me, okay? So I was talking about, being patient and like just looking at where you're at and just fucking owning it. Like maybe where you're at is like, I'm really smart. I'm doing this work. I'm starting to recognize all these pieces of myself like, oh, but I'm not taking action. So instead of being like, well, what's wrong with me? Why am I not taking action? Blah, blah, blah. Like, that's so stupid. Why do we do that? That's just more inaction. It's just sitting there pondering things that are so fucking irrelevant. Instead of being like, okay, cool, that's good information. I've now worked far enough and hard enough to get to the place where I can see my ahas, I can see where I'm going off, I can see like through this fog, and I can see that I haven't taken action yet. And that's fucking exciting, because if I have this much going on for me when I'm seeing the things, imagine what it's gonna look like when I fucking start backing it up and I'm starting to take massive instant action right after I have these ahas. It's like something to get excited about, not a thing for us to go beat ourselves up about, right? So currently, just being completely vulnerable and transparent with you guys. In my business, right? 2 years ago, I was literally making $400 a week and just so in the weeds, right? And so 2 years later, we have a $500,000 business and retreats all over the world, et cetera, which still feels like how's that my fucking life? Oh, so it's so fast, right? So here we are, you know, I got a team, everything like that. The business is going incredible. We'll definitely hit millions. Like, it's just on track. It's what it is, right? Where I'm at currently, and this, like, I think it's so important for people to see the reality of what it actually looks like, not some bullshit fantasy we have in our head so that we can go compare ourselves and then beat the shit out of ourselves, because it's supposed to look a different way, right? And I am the queen of just saying the shit like it is. Like, what you see is what you get. If you needed some perfect person to model, then I'm not your fucking girl, because I am far from perfect, right? So currently, as it sits right now, I watch myself and I look at it, and I used to judge myself and beat myself up, and I slip into it every now and again, and you know, and then I'll reach out for support because I know when I'm off, because I start feeling down and I start feeling like everybody else is doing good except for me. That's when I know I've gotten off track and I reach out for support, right? So the way it looks for me is like, I show up pretty consistently in my business. I'm kind of a machine in my business, right? Like, so, you know, here's a perfect example. I'm doing this free group because that's what I intuitively felt a prompt to do when I was journaling and even in the middle of moving, which makes no fucking logical sense, but I did it anyway, right? So like, I'm kind of a machine that way. When I feel a prompting and I know it's a thing to do, whether I feel like it or not, I show up and I get it done, right? So I'm really proud of myself for that. And that wasn't always true. There was so much stuff I had to work through, right? As I watch and I just assess where I'm at now without judgment, just like, cool, this is where I'm at in my 10-year fucking plan. I notice I'm not consistent with my eating and with working out. I definitely notice I still tend to like absorb things and then use emotional eating to help get myself through. I notice definitely that I still like times when I would love to be reading something that's really nourishing, I'll check out and watch, you know, House or some other whatever show that I love and is entertaining, which is fine most of the time. But I also notice that there's time it's not fine. I'm numbing instead of choosing something that's more nourishing, going for a walk outside in nature. So like, I notice full well, like, wow, if I'm doing this well while I'm still emotionally eating a bit, I'm still noticing that I'm like, I don't lean into the chaos in complete calm. I get a little frantic and a little like, oh, like in the buzz, which I love most of the time when I need it. Everything's a double-edged sword, right? Like, I love being able to get that hustle bustle and that drive on, but I also would love to be a lot better at like calming down and tuning in kind of on key. So like, I can look at it like, yeah, I really am not that great at tuning in and calming down in that inner depth and peace like I would like to, like I envision myself to. Yeah, my eating's not on point. I still notice that I'll go for that bar of chocolate when like I look at the house and like everything's a shit show and the kids are running around like crazy and there's a bunch of packing to do and my husband's gone and my son is pissing me off with his grades and whatever, whatever, right? And I'll be like, oh, walk right over to that piece of chocolate. Like, I notice I still do these things. So I could look at it and judge myself and be like, oh, you know, so-and-so doesn't do that. And oh my God, look at, she has all this. Or she has 26,000 followers and I only have 7,000 followers or whatever it is, right? Like I could get into that just like every other human being, but I've trained myself not to because it doesn't serve anyone. So I get to just see it as information. Like, okay, cool. I'm still needing support and resources. I still have some healing to do with emotional eating. I still have bulimic for 21 years, right? Like there's still healing to be done there. And there's still healing for me to do with being able to calm the fuck down and really go to a deeper level in my soul. I'm so grateful that I'm able to hear like an intuitive prompt and act on it. That has taken me really far. But like, what's it gonna look like when I'm able to like really like just stop? Just like really stop and like go all the way in. I'm really excited about what that's gonna fucking look like. So the point of this being, and then I'm gonna look at the more ahas and actions. The point of this being, it's not something to judge yourself for. It's not something to criticize. There's no, like, you're never gonna arrive at this place where like, oh, now all the ducks are in a row and I'm perfect. Like that shit doesn't fucking happen. You have come this far. Listen to me for a second, okay? I want you to hear this. So if you're doing something else, stop for 1 second, just tune in. You have come this far so that you had the strength, the wisdom, and the courage to go to the next level. So guess what that means? It means when you get to the next level, it's gonna be the same fucking thing. You have gonna come that far to have the strength, wisdom, and courage to get to the next level. This is a never-ending journey. You're never just gonna get somewhere and be like, oh yeah, I'm done. I'm done growing now. I'm done learning. I'm done healing. I've just arrived. This just is the thing, right? And it's never gonna be the fucking money that drives you. It's gonna be the journey and the growth and the healing and the learning. So you might as well learn right fucking now. If you think that it's money that's going to get to the place where you can enjoy life and sort of have peace and be still, nope, I fucking promise you that, right? As a girl who was on food stamps who now has a $500,000 business, I promise you it's not money. Right? I really mean that. It's not money that's going to shift that. It's a choice. It's a deliberate choice and backing it up right fucking now. You shifting off of the bullshit and onto the positive and onto the goal and onto letting things be what they are. Genuine surrender. Like I am in complete surrender that my eating is not perfect and that like being able to tune in and go deep is not perfect. No judgment, zero judgment. And I know I'll get there. I know it'll just keep getting better and better. And that's what I tell myself. I'm getting closer and closer. Every day I'm getting better and better. This is getting cleaned up more and more, right? So now I have my workout routine consistently. Now I'm working out consistently, finally. I used to have a fucking story. Every time I up-leveled, every time I hit a new number in the business, like we started hitting 50K months, and the story was, oh, every time I up-level, I get sick. Every time I invest in a new mentor or I you know, do something that's new in my business, like I put out two new streams of income for my business, I get sick. That used to be my story. So one time I looked at it like, okay, I know this is bullshit. I don't need to get sick every time I up-level. That's complete shit. I don't know who taught me that or how I picked up on that, but it's shit. So I got my ass up and I walked and I pushed through and it went away and I was fine. Whereas before it would have taken a couple weeks and I would have been trying to figure out why I'm such a piece of shit that gets sick every time I up-level and what's wrong with me. So I'm growing, I'm changing, I'm getting better, and it's certainly not fucking perfect, but I'm getting there and it'll keep getting better. That's the way we need to look at stuff. Like, let's stop pretending that it's not what it is. Let's stop pretending that we're better than we are. Let's stop pretending that we're worse than we are. Let's stop pretending it's so fucking hard. Let's stop pretending we don't know what it is or that we don't know what to do, right? And let's start just being in surrender and accepting who the fuck we are, what we want, what we know we're born to do, right? And then we can look at like, okay, these are the pieces that I would like an up level. And then what the fuck are you gonna do about it? What are you actually gonna do to shift that, right? Like I take massive action. I have full blown support with my eating, with the emotions, with how I'm processing and allowing my emotions to go through. And I have full blown support in building my business and taking massive steps in my business, right? Like I see those areas a week, I pull in resource, period, end of story, right? And you deserve to have resource. You deserve to have support. You're not meant to go do this struggling by your fucking self. And we're getting into some things today that I think will help you feel safer doing it. All right, let me check out this feed. I need this so much. I do have that problem of getting in emotionally and then not backing it up because I have realized, yeah, hashtag human. Because I have realized I thought it would be enough or I didn't know how, yeah. Like, oh, I feel like I'm gonna do it, so that's better, or that's enough. It's not fucking enough. It's not enough. Let's just say what it is. It's not enough to just feel like you're gonna do something. It only matters if you fucking actually do it. I don't know how is the number one thing that I hear. I don't know who I'm meant to serve. I don't, like, if you think about that for one second, can I just say this to you? Let's just say you're a coach or you're some sort of support role for other people. And you're saying to another human being, I don't know who I'm meant to serve. How, and I'm not saying that people can never ask me this, because I'm gonna fucking always give you what you need for you to figure out. But let me just say this to you. Who the fuck do you think is gonna answer that question for you? This is my rock rendition. Who's gonna fucking tell you who your soul's meant to show up and serve? And why are we giving that much power to other people? I don't think that's what you're intending to do, is like, well, instead of going inward and really listening to my guidance and my intuition, I'm going to ask someone else who I'm meant to serve. Or because I got some fucking script, or because someone laid this out for me, then I'm just going to serve those people. It's okay to start there, just like if I do a modified version of a workout, it's okay to start there. Right? But that's not the goal. The goal isn't to stay there. And I'm not fucking confused that I don't always want to do a modified push-up forever. I want to do the fucking push-up and I know how to do it. I'm just not strong enough to do it yet. That's okay. It's okay to start where you need to fucking start. But like, can we stop giving our power away? Right? This is really like a moment of taking your power back. Like, I'm going to stop pretending that I'm not being chaotic and not tuning in. And then I'm asking other people frantically, like, I don't know who this is. Like, someone else is going to give me the answer of who my fucking soul is meant to show up and serve in this life. Let's not do that, right? The truth is, your ass is frantic and you need support calming the fuck down, staying tuned in and staying on track and being able to listen to your soul guidance moving forward and trust your instincts. You're a fucking woman. Your instincts are next level. You were born with like some high level shit inside of you that you have not tapped into, because you need to not be asking other people what your purpose is, right? And not to be confusing, because at the same fucking moment, if that's the thing you need to ask to get the clarity, then fucking ask. Don't ever not ask something, right? All I'm saying is like, recognize it for what it is while you're asking. Like, it's like me saying like, I just don't know how to do a push-up. That's not true. I know how to do a push-up. I'm just not strong enough to do a push-up yet. I'm not in the practice yet. I haven't seasoned myself to the point where my body remembers how to do that. Just like you haven't seasoned yourself enough where your body remembers how to fucking tune in and get your answer. So it's okay to ask, because someone will help you. Just like if I said that to a personal trainer, he's going to get me there one way or another, right? All right. The last time of watching you, I learned and grew so much. I love when you say, stop fucking pretending you don't know what to do. I know what to do. I'm doing a Facebook this afternoon. I'm so excited. No scripts, no planning. I just know I'm doing it. Just so you guys know, right? I was actually talking to my mom about this morning. Like, I didn't plan anything yesterday. Not one word of what I said to you guys yesterday was planned, and not one word of today is planned, right? And so like, there's times when I'm like, well, maybe it'd be a little more structured and neater. Yeah, but I'm not gonna intuitively give you guys, I just made my hair crazy. I'm not gonna intuitively give you guys what I feel you need in the moment when I'm doing that, right? So I've learned to trust myself to just fucking show up and let my purpose come out. Like, let it come through me, and I and me and my shit is not gonna muck it up because I need to look perfect or know and feel comfortable that I'm gonna say all the right things, right? So thank God I've outgrown that behavior. And I was there before where I wanted it to be about me. I wanted to be the one that looked good. I wanted to have all the answers. I wanted to be able to help everyone. And I fucked shit up a lot. So instead, I've gotten to the place where I'm just like, okay, all right, God, do your thing. Do your thing. I'm on board. Let this shit come out, right? Which is a completely different way of living. So that is a huge move, Amy Gray. Congratulations. And anyone who does a live today, because I'm just hearing a lot of lives, this isn't about doing Facebook Lives per se, but anyone who does a live today, feel free to share the link in the comments below so that we can go blow your shit up too. And we all can support each other, right? Because this is about teamwork. I said, I don't have time for blank last night. Beth Stewart, right on. It was something keeping me stuck because I was letting it. This is my favorite phrase to myself. I'm no longer available for blank. Right? I literally use this with my kids, right? Like, oh, I can't because blah, blah, blah. My son like makes it complicated about his grades or something. Like, I'm no longer available for these kind of conversations. I'm no longer available for arguing with you, right? With bulimia, it was like, I'm no longer available for bulimia. Like, I'm just not. Like, it's been 2 years ago where it stopped being a compulsive behavior, right? Maybe it was like 2.5 years ago. Oh, it was like 3 years ago now. Wow, that's cool. It's like 3 years ago now. right? Like, I'm no longer available for this feeling that I'm feeling, right? Like, if we're in that chaotic, frantic feeling, it's like, I'm just fucking no longer available for this. Like, what does it look like if you're literally, like, 100% no longer available for that bullshit? Like, what would that, everything, do you see? Once you make that decision and back it up, everything else has to shift and change. It's all required to shift and change after you make the decision that I'm no longer available for that. Oh yeah, you're still there, cool. I had an alarm go off, right? So internally, for yourself, I'm no longer available for me showing up that way. And I'm no longer available for whatever external thing that feels jarring and hard and like, you know you're not available for. It does not feel in alignment to show up that fucking way, right? I'm no longer available for that shit. That's the wording that might resonate with you. I'm addicted to the calm and going within. Hell yes. I need to learn to not judge myself when my diet is not where I need or want it to be. Thanks for sharing that. Hell yes. Listen, we know this. This is like common sense. It's spiritual and it's science. It's all three. When you're sitting there in judgment or criticism of whatever the fucking behavior is, I don't care if you're like not showing up how you want to in your business, if you are, you know, eating foods that you're like not in alignment with you and not lined up with who you want to be, if you're not showing up and you're working out, if you're not showing up in your relationship, if you're not being vulnerable with your husband, if you're not speaking up and you're not asking for what you need, or you're not speaking your truth, or you've gotten stuck in a cycle of playing the victim or whatever the fuck it is, I don't care. In no way, shape, or form does sitting there criticizing yourself serve anyone or help you get to the next level. It's the same shit. It's like, so if you're like, oh, why won't I just show up and work out? How come I just keep, I go for 2 weeks and then I quit, right? What does that help you to sit there and criticize it that way and be like, oh, what the fuck? Do you think like what the fucking yourself into it is gonna get you to actually show up and do it? Negative energy cannot bring positive results, period. End of story. You can't like negative yourself into positive. It doesn't even fucking make any sense. And you can't negative someone else into positive. You just stay your ass in your own lane and focus on you and your shit instead of worrying about what they're doing and what they're not doing, right? This is literally like about actually recognizing that until I'm vibrating at the place of inviting this and welcoming it in, I cannot have it, right? Which actually leads me to point one on what I'm going to teach you guys today, right? It's actually, I didn't put it in here. I didn't choose that for today, but I'm going to say it anyway. So, God will not give you something that you're not ready to receive. He's not going to override your free will and give you something that you're not ready for. So while you're in a place of like, I'm so bad, I just can't do this, I don't know, this is hard, there's no receive, there's no room to receive, there's nothing. There's zero space to receive, there's zero space to grow, there's zero space for you to expand. It's done, it's dead in the water, right? And it even makes sense if you think about it, you don't have to believe the spiritual aspects behind it, but I don't know why we wouldn't, right? Everything in the entire universe backs up this principle. There is zero things in the entire universe that go against the principle that there is abundance, and that when you are in the vibration, when you are in, if that word doesn't resonate with everyone, how else would I describe it? When you're in the energy of, when you're in the mindset of, I know I can do this, I know it's getting better, I know I'm on my way, there is now room for growth. Otherwise, you are clutching and you are holding on, white knuckling it, and there is no fucking room. There's no room. It's not any different than you saying like, okay, I really want to hire someone to come in and help me with my business. And someone comes in and you hire them. And every time they go to do something, you're like, oh, no, not like that, like this. Never mind, I got it done. And you just did that the whole time. Never mind, I got it done. Never mind, I got it done. Nope. Like, because you were so worried about it being done perfect. There's no fucking room for them to show up. So then you're going to be like, I knew I wouldn't be supported. See, I knew nobody would help me. Or you do it to your husband. You clean the house and then you're like, see, he never helps me. Well, you just fucking clean the house. How are you blaming his ass, right? There's no room for growth if that's what you're doing. So God will not come down and just like override your free will and just dump money or dump freedom or dump joy or dump whatever on you when you aren't fucking open to receiving it. Does this make sense? I needed to hear this. Being in surrender, I love that. Self-judgment sabotage. My big takeaway, you can never leave anyone behind, was super helpful reminder. You can't. I should get into that more. Those that fall away are meant to because the vibration no longer matches and totally perfectly okay. This has been subconscious fear that has recently come to light. Look, we're heart-centered people who love people and care and want to help and heal people. But there's also an arrogance when we think that, like, oh, somehow I'm meant to override that person's soul journey and their decisions as a fucking grown-ass adult or human being, and their free will to actually choose whatever soul's journey that they choose, and I'm somehow supposed to come in and interrupt and change that without them directly actually being open to expanding into that. Does this make sense? Like, what the fuck? Everybody around you is getting exactly what they want. They are getting what they want. They can bitch about it and say how hard it is, but guess what? They're still fucking choosing it just like you. All the circumstances and what you have in your life is exactly what you want. There is a reason that you are choosing the shit that you are choosing. There's a reason you're getting a payoff. There's a payoff to it. There's something that you're getting that feels more important to you than the result that you keep talking about that you want. And that's true for everybody else. So what that does is, one, it gives you the power to fucking step into your own shit. But two, it releases you from the, what's the word, responsibility of trying to fix other people or get them some kind of result that they're unwilling to fucking show up and do the work for. How does that serve them? They have to want to show up and do the work, and everything that's available for you has been available for them consistently, and they can opt into it or they cannot, but that's their soul's journey. And I read this thing one time in the Message Bible. It was a long time ago, and it said, even angels don't tread in that sacred ground. And it was talking about the space between man and God. Like, me and my journey, my soul's journey, is between me and God. And how dare someone else come and tread in that space as if it were their space to do it. That's between them and God. And everybody's getting exactly what they want. You always win the game that you're playing. And their behavior might not make any damn sense to you, but subconsciously it does for them. So hell yes, there's no such thing as leaving anyone behind. There's just literally, I mean, unless you're a Marine, which I was, and you're in a battleground and someone got shot and they're literally lying there dying, there's no fucking such thing as leaving somebody behind. It's a bullshit story that keeps you in someone else's lane, going 90 miles over into their lane so that you can focus on them, so you don't have to focus on your own shit. Right? I know. That was a big struggle of mine. I did that for a long time. I still do it sometimes. Luckily, my husband knows the language of get out of my lane. Get in your own lane. Exactly. I've done a lot of public speaking. It always goes better when I don't try to plan what I say. Yes. Getting the habit of planning ahead. Plus aha decision with immediate action in the moment. Step, step, step. Yes, Jen. Fuck yes. Oh my God. Girls. Yes. Girls tracking. Yes. Nailed it, Jen. Brilliant. Trusting the message to come through you is so much better than stressing and being overwhelmed with a script that doesn't come out perfect. Like, literally, even when I run my retreats, I tell people what they're going to learn, just like I told you guys what you're going to learn here. And I did go back to the website and be like, oh, what did I promise them? Right? But those are just general ideas, but whatever comes out, comes out. It's the same with the retreats, right? And they're always exactly perfect. It's so perfect. But it does take a lot of faith and a lot of balls for you to show up and be you and let the message come through you versus you trying to control it and look perfect. And I'm not saying you can't ever prep. Go ahead. I have slides here, just like ideas like that might pop in. And I'm going to go through scarcity and abundance thinking with you guys today. And I have that slide here. Like, that's fine. And if you want to plan out every little thing, go ahead. But if you feel a fucking intuitive prompt for you to do something else, your ass better follow that shit. That's going to be 100,000 times more powerful, right? Another amazing reminder to just trust that I know what I need to know and that I will share exactly what I need to when I just show up. Hell yes, Mandy. Oh my God, you guys are on fire this morning. And it's morning. Unless there's people around the world and it's nighttime for them. I do know, actually, I got some messages. UK. I got some UKs on here and some Australians that it's nighttime for them. This is good. I'm no longer available to judge myself. So remember, Christy, what we shared yesterday. When you find yourself judging yourself, because you're not going to be perfect, you get to be like, oh, like it's like a DJ, like, arr. All right, you just literally get to like slam on the brakes and choose something else in the moment. You don't have to be like, oh my God, why did I do that? Like, don't go deeper into it. Literally just be like, ha, I see what you're trying to do there. I notice. Nope, not today. Not today, Satan. Andrea, if you pop on here, that was for you. She said that to me one time when I was talking about food stuff. And like there was pizza or something and she said, not today, Satan, which is hysterical, right? No longer available, fuck yes. So remember, we don't have to go further into it. We don't have to understand why we did it. We don't have to do all those stupid things that we do that procrastinate us from actually shifting and taking the action we would have been doing if we weren't fucking sitting there judging ourselves, right? I just wrote a blog post about it. You are ready for whatever's coming your way. Hell yes. Feel free to share that in this comments, Lilia. I'm no longer available for self-destruction. I am creative, so I choose self-creation. Hell yes. Healing, life, growth, creation, sharing, calling people's ass to more. All yes. Hey, Jackie. I am crying when you said the comment about God and receiving. Yes, Sarah. He has been giving me signs and I'm turning my back on it. We're ready when we're ready. And this is like literally everything I wanted to cover you guys today was basically just the idea of, where is that slide on my things? It's about giving permission to the universe, giving God permission to actually flood us with abundance, because there is so much more coming your way and goodness, and we get to be wide open to receiving all good things. Like, we just get to. And it is a process to get to the place where we're open to receiving. And so let me see if I can teach this correctly. It's a concept I know and have never actually taught. When you are at the place where you only allow in support, let's just use support as a perfect example. This will come to mind, okay? So let's say, I'm just going to use me as an example. I was coaching, and I wanted to invest. I wanted to go to the next level. Not all my money was being spent, right? It was all on, like, this is what I made, and this is what my expenses were, and that was that. There was no other wiggle room. But I wanted to invest in something else. I wanted support. I wanted the money to be able to hire a mentor, right? So what I started to understand, and like I was reading Course in Miracles and stuff like that, and what I started to understand was I'm sitting there asking for God to give me the resource to hire the mentor. But I had the $2,000, right? Like, I had the $2,000 in my account to invest in that first, the first month with that mentor, right? So like, there was a track with me for 1 second. This is really, really, really fucking huge. If you get this, this is so big, okay? I had the $2,000 in my account, but that money was accounted for to pay my bills that month. That was like a lot of money to me back then, right? $400 a week I was making. So it was $2,000 I had to pay my fucking bills, or I could use that $2,000 to pay the mentor. So there I was sitting asking God, like, God, please help me. Like, I just need $2,000. And like, I definitely got this intuitive prompt, like, you have $2,000. So like, being able to use the resource in the moment that I needed. And I'm not saying to, you know, I'm not telling anyone to do anything. I'm sharing a story with you and I'm trying to get a concept across to you. So just track with me for a second without getting triggered. I'm not telling you to go use all your bill money to fucking buy a mentor. It's not what I'm saying. Track with me. Okay. Let that shit go for 2 seconds and just hear me. I used the $2,000 to invest in the mentor. And then I was like, fuck, I needed another 1,000 in 2 weeks for that program that I did. And I also now needed to replace the 2,000 that I just spent to pay my bills. So I'm on the airplane home and I'm just like, oh my God, what did I just do? I'm like, God, I really feel like you told me to do this. So what's the fucking deal? I feel like you gave me permission. Like, you have everything you need. Why are you asking me for something that you don't need? You already have it. So what I did was I created a gap. I literally created a need. So I was asking for something before I actually had a fucking need for it. I had the resources to take step one. I just didn't have the resources to cover step 2, 3, and 4. So here I am praying for God to cover steps 2, 3, and 4 before I've even taken step fucking one, right? So I took step number one. And after step number one, then I prayed, okay, God, now I legit have a need. I have actually created a need, which is the place where most people are completely unwilling to live. They are not willing to live in the tension of faith. Of like, okay, God, I felt an intuitive prompting there, or soul, whatever resonates with you, universe, right? Like, I felt an intuitive prompting there, I did it, and now I actually have a need. Versus, no, that's not safe, I need to control it. I'm the only thing that can give me what I need. I'm the only thing that can produce the things I need. I'm actually not gonna step out in faith and trust that everything's gonna be okay, and trust that a path will form when there actually wasn't a way for that to happen. I couldn't see at step one how I was gonna make it happen. My brain was at $400 a week. I literally could not see it. But I felt that intuitive prompt. I took that action. On the plane ride home, I booked a client for $2,000, got home, booked another client for $2,000. My first two clients at that price, I had $1,000 over what I needed for the first time ever, just like that. And I did nothing different besides show up and continue to listen to those prompts. So I started recognizing, like, holy shit, that's why nobody gets success in this area. People aren't able to have success because they're not willing to feel that tension I felt in the moment when I backed myself up and I trusted my instincts and I created a need and had faith that my needs would be met on the other side of that. I trusted myself to show up and I trusted God to show up. I trusted that my intuitive prompt meant something. I trusted that when I create a need, it's going to be fucking met. right? And that is something that I watch most people are unwilling to do. Like, if people want to join, they're like, oh my God, I know I need to do this, but I only know that I can pay the first 3 months. I don't know how I'll pay after that, right? To me, I'm like, oh shit, I had fucking 1 week. You have 3 months. That's nothing, right? I don't say that, but that's something I know because I've grown through this and I can see it from the outside perspective. The person in it is just like, I don't know. Like, how do I know I'll recoup this back? How do I know I'll be successful? Are you going to show the fuck up? Because if you're going to show the fuck up, then you know. Because you decided. How do you know? Because you fucking decided and you said so. Because you said, I'm going to fucking do this no matter what it takes. I'm going to stay in alignment and I'm going to fucking back this up and I'm going to make it happen, right? Can you see why most people are unwilling to do this? Because they're not willing to take step one without knowing for sure that step two, three, and four are going to work. But guess what? You don't fucking get to know that. That's not how it works. That's why life is rigged for the bold. That's why the bold are the ones who are out there crushing it, because other people are unwilling to feel that tension in that moment. You guys track with what I'm saying? And you can see all the times in your life, if you look back, I wonder what life would look like if all those times you hit that place where you were like, oh, yes, I want to do this, but I don't know how steps 2, 3, 4, and you couldn't stay in the moment and lean into that and allow yourself to feel that tension and expand in the tension and allow space for a need to come in so that God could flood you. Right? It's hard for people to do that. Okay, totally makes sense. We can't assert into another experience. We attract all individually. Yes. Realizing what that payoff is everything. Totally helps break the pattern. Yes. Oh, my shit is showing. I'm not really hiding and protecting myself, am I? Yes, love it. My shit is pretty. Analysis paralysis. None of that shit. Nothing is worse than indecision. 27 fuck-ups in a row is better than one indecision. This is so true. For the past week, I only allowed positive energy and support, no judgment. And as soon as I was spiraling down, I did whatever it takes to get me back, and so fucking working. I see you, Lilia. Hell yes. And it just feels so freaking amazing. And not only does it feel amazing, but you're taking fucking massive action. You're getting results. So you're getting the reward on the other side of this as well. I see you, girl. Brilliant. Yep, I'm tracking with you, sister. Awesome. So hard. If you say so. If you say so. I say it's fucking easy. I say we get to create a need and then we get to watch God fill it, and that's pretty fucking easy. I think what's hard is when we live in the belief system that we can only have what we show up and create. That's the only way to have it. That there's like these blocks that we trade. Like, I have this resource and I'm going to give this and I'll get this in return and we're just going to keep trading. So I only have a certain amount of time and a certain amount of money and a certain amount of mental energy and a certain amount of willpower and discipline, and that's all I have. And I can only have in the world what I can see myself actually showing up and creating. And there's no room whatsoever for the universe to get back to us. That's hard, right? I've been doing that my whole life, but it never made sense. I just call it luck. Yes, it's not fucking luck, right? That's why people see me and they're like, oh, like, this was just so easy for her. In like 2 years, she just built this. Like, she's so lucky. Not fucking lucky. I was willing to stand in that tension over and over and over until it got to the place where I'm like, okay, now it's not that hard anymore, because I now know, right? Like, I'm like, oh, I need to hire a new team member and I'm going to have to pull in an A team member. So I know it's going to cost me a lot of money, and like, the business isn't ready for that. And there I go, stepping into the tension. I take the action, the massive action, because I feel the intuitive prompt to do it, trusting and knowing that everything's going to work out on the other side of that. I just want to have the cushion. Fuck the cushion. That is definitely the new hashtag. Hold on, we're adding this. Hashtag fuck the cushion. How do you spell cushion? C-U-S-H. My team is always making fun of me because I spell terribly. Yes, that is definitely the hashtag of this video. Hashtag fuck the cushion. So I have another one. I'll explain this to you for a minute. It's called fuck the pot. So it's very much along this theme. So a bonsai tree, if you've ever heard of a bonsai tree, grows this little big on, and you put it on your desk and you trim it, those little Japanese bonsai trees. And the reason they stay so small is because they're in this tiny little pot, right? Did you know if you take that tree out and plant it outside, it grows into this massive, ginormous tree, right? So you put yourself in this little tiny beliefs in these like boxes, and you stay small, and you get to be this little hood ornament for somebody else who's living fucking big's desk, right? But if you take your ass and put yourself in a big pot where there's not all these rules, and you're taking that action, that one step in front of you, and having faith that the next ones will work out, then you'll fucking grow really big. So I made this up, was like, fuck the pot. is like, fuck the pot. I'm going to grow as big and badass as I can. Like, I'm out in the Maui Valley and I just get to like expand all over the entire island. Right? Fuck the cushion. It is good. That is good, girl. You did good on that one. Okay. Permission to the universe. I'm going to go through these with you guys, okay? What do you believe is true about you? I'm buying a bonsai tree, right? Yeah, but you're not going to keep that shit in a little pot. Either that or you should and just write fuck the pot on it. You keep saying things that are making me laugh out loud this morning. Good. That's awesome. Okay. What do you believe is true about you? What time is it? Ooh, 10:50. Okay. What do you believe is true about you? The kind of things that we remember when I said we're just looking at things as information, like, okay, this is just information for me to have. No judgment. It's just like, it's good to get to fucking know yourself. Hi, do you know you? Right? What do you believe is true about you? What do you believe is possible for you? Do you believe it's right? Like right now, I literally believe it's possible for me to have a $1 billion company, multiple companies that are all multi-million dollars, right? And have like Mandy Perry Inc. be a $1 billion company. I did, clearly, obviously, didn't always believe that, but I have done a lot of work, and now I know that I'm just headed there. It's just a matter of like how much tension can I handle and enjoy life and still like and grow at that pace. I just get to enjoy the process, right? Yes, thank you, Christy. How much support can you accept? One of the biggest things when I started doing this was I wanted support, and I was bitching. This is why I gave that example. I was bitching about not having enough support in my life, but then every time someone tried to support me, I would fucking control it. Just ask Susan. She's like, can you just fucking give me a second to do that, please? I'd be like, never mind, it's already done. I had to learn. I had to get to a place. I used to have this story that people don't do things well, they don't do things like me, and they don't care about it like I do because it's not for them. Instead of knowing that people are good, they're fucking epic, they're smart, they're intuitive, they're instinctive, they love to help, they love to show up, right? So I got to shift that belief, and then I got to own the stuff that I was doing that was also creating it, right? So how much support can you accept? How much financial abundance can you handle? You will not get one penny beyond what you can handle. The reason that my, like any potential clients I have out there are not, or the reason any coaches out there are not getting $10,000 per client is because they don't have a fucking offer for $10,000 a client. Nobody comes to me and they're like, Mandy, I've had this $10,000 program. I really worked it out. I love it. I'm excited about it. I keep sharing it and nobody will buy it. I did it for a whole year. Not one person joined. Not one person has ever said that to me because that has never fucking happened. The only thing they say to me is like, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm worried that I'm going to annoy people. I'm blah, 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 blah. All the excuses, right? So you have not because you believe not, right? How much financial abundance can you accept, right? What's the most you can receive per month per client? How about we just break it down like that? How much can you receive every month for your coaching? How much can you perceive yourself? And let's do some work to expand that, right? Are you creating needs? Are you allowing yourself to live in a way that's all in and you're creating needs? Can you live in that tension and create a need? Can you just allow yourself to learn what it feels like to like breathe through that tension and have some faith and get a taste of what it's like on the other fucking side? Because it's awesome. So fucking awesome. It really is, right? How happy are you allowed to be? How do you create a $10,000 program? What does that look like? Yeah, you just sit your ass down and create it. The only reason you don't know what it looks like because you didn't sit your ass down and create it yet, right? That's like the biggest thing with people. I don't know how to do this. That's only because you didn't actually sit down and do it because you were telling yourself you didn't know how to do it, so you never bothered to sit down and do it. I still have to call myself out on this. I still do it. It's probably the thing that pisses me off the most. I have to remember there's no judgment. I'm at where I'm at. Everything will get better, right? How loved are you allowed to be? I feel like there's something wrong too. How loved are you allowed to be? How famous can you allow yourself to be? I used to think that if I had like even the level of fame I have now, I used to be like, no. I was such a private person, such a like, I don't want to deal with people looking at me. Like I went to modeling when I was younger and I went on stage one time and I literally walked off and was like, I cannot deal with all the people looking at me. Like I never needed people to look at me. I never needed that stuff, right? I have other people in my life, that's really a drive for them. But the story in my head was, they'll all take me down with them. Like, the more people I have around me, the more people I have to rescue and save, and they're all gonna fucking suffocate me. That's why I couldn't handle being seen, right? I couldn't handle being loved by people. I just couldn't, because I thought I was gonna have to rescue them all. So I had to work, I got to, right? Like, being in that situation and being called to that was kind of like the reluctant leader, and I got to work through the patterns and the stories that came up for me that made me feel like I was suffocated when people liked me. That's like not a fucking pattern I wanted to have. Of course I wanna be loved. Of course I want people to like me. Of course I want them to share their love and their appreciation or the ahas and the breakthroughs. Like, I'm a fucking human being. It makes me feel good, right? So how loved are you allowing yourself to be? Can you allow yourself to be seen? Can you allow people to enjoy you, to look up to you, to learn from you, to revere you? Can you allow those things, right? And how many friends are you allowed to have show up for you? So many women I see isolate, and they won't allow themselves to have deep friendships because there's some kind of story that, like, well, if they see the real me, they're not gonna like me, or then I'm gonna have to show up for them, or whatever the stories are, right? Can you allow yourself to expand in the close friendships and the meaningful friendships that you have, the tribe? Can you be part of a tribe? A lot of times when people, like now I think people know that I run groups, right? But like in the beginning, people were like, well, can I just do one-on-one? Because I don't really feel comfortable sharing a group. Of course you fucking don't, because you've been isolating for 30 years. No more fucking isolating. It's why we run groups. They're 10,000 times more powerful, right? They're so much more powerful. And it's vulnerable for people to learn to share in the group. Even you guys sharing the comments down here publicly, like, that's vulnerable shit. It's powerful, right? I give you guys so much credit for that. It's a big deal. Okay. I'm going to run these by you, okay? And then I'm going to look at the comments. I didn't write down who wrote these. They're just some of my favorite quotes, and I didn't feel like looking them up. Sometimes we must move forward in faith until our way is illuminated. Sometimes we must move forward. There's a reason why all the fucking people ahead of us are teaching us this shit, right? Maybe now we have ears to hear a little bit better. Sometimes we must move forward in faith until our way is illuminated. Faith is taking the first step even when you don't see the whole staircase, right? I'm going to reach out and be romantic with my husband even though I'm afraid that he's not going to reciprocate. I'm gonna reach out and say sorry, even though what they did was fucked up. Taking the step in faith, even when you don't see the whole staircase. I'm gonna invest in this thing I need support with. I'm gonna move forward. I'm gonna fucking back myself, even though I don't know how it's all gonna work out. Everything you've ever wanted is right outside of your comfort zone. Remember we talked about the tension that we feel? Like, you're gonna feel tension when you do that because it's not fucking familiar to you yet, right? I don't feel as much tension as I used to, not even close. It takes courage to get clarity. First you step out and then clarity comes. Not, I'm gonna sit here and I'm gonna figure it all out and then I'll know, right? Like, just like the $10,000 program, right? Like, well, I don't really know. I know, because you haven't sat down and done it, right? The courage to sit down and write out a $10,000 program like it's yours. Then on the other side, it's like, whoa, I have so much more clarity on that. Stepping out, like, I don't know how to do like an off the cuff Facebook Live. Well, it's gonna take courage. Show up and do the fucking Facebook Live and then be like, wow, okay, that was a lot easier. I noticed I could have done this or this. I'll do that next time, right? Courage gets clarity. I don't know how I'm gonna do this whole thing in my business is gonna work out, but I'm gonna fucking step in. I'm gonna get a tribe. I'm gonna get a mentor. I'm actually gonna step into this. And then on the other side of that, I'll have clarity on how to move to the next step, right? It's like, first we take that first step. A real decision is measured, this is Tony Robbins. I said this yesterday. A real decision is measured by the fact that you've taken a new action. If there is no action, you haven't truly decided. We get that, right? If there's no action, you have not decided. You've just had an emotion. All right, one more thing I'm gonna run through. Let me check the comments first. Worldwide, bring it on. Hell yeah, girl. It does feel good. I remember when I hit worldwide. Whew, it was a good feeling. It was a great sense of accomplishment and a lot of excitement about like, what new belief systems are going to come up that I can support women through, and you know, like, what is the different life structure over where they live, and like, how much more healing can I create in the world, and daydreaming, allowing myself to daydream about the impact that I might be able to have, and really letting myself soar into these daydreams about just healing millions of women, and just staying on track with that goal, and just keep going, and allowing God to do his thing through me, and not thinking like, but I'm a mess. How am I going to help them? It's not just about me. It's about me being willing to be in that tension and take that guided action that I feel. So then big things can happen through me, right? it's actually very egotistical for us to be like, well, it's all about me and what I can produce for these people. And it's very, and thinking that our assessment of ourselves is more important than God's assessment of us. That's the egotistical thing. It's actually humble for us to be like, God's assessment of me is that I'm huge and capable of incredible things, and he's leading me to do this, so I'm going to trust him, and I'm going to take my shit out of it, right? I totally get the suffocating feeling. Yep. We get to release it. That just hit home. How loved and how famous can I allow myself to be? It's really big. Right? We think we want something, but then we're like, okay, do I really want that? And what does that mean? What is that going to look like? And how much am I allowing myself to have it? Because if I don't create a need, if I don't create a space, then there can't be any receiving. I want to be famous, but the words that come to mind when I think that is, I'm prideful and boastful and making it about me. I have work to do here. I know those are lies. It's everything that we've been taught, right? Like, I rarely remember when I was a kid, I used to love singing, and I remember being told, God will only let you sing when you stop wanting it or needing it, which is total bullshit, but I didn't know any better. So we've been taught in our culture that it's boastful and it's prideful for us to make it about us, but we're not actually making it about us, are we? If you dig down, if you distill that, right? Like, it's like, if we just take a microscope and we're looking at something and it's like right here, like we can't see anything else, that's what we see. It's like, yeah, I'm boastful and I'm prideful, and then we're all done. Play that shit out for a second. Why do you want to be famous? Why does that matter to you? I'm guessing you want the power to be able to change lives. You want the power to be able to actually create transformation in this world and leave a legacy of healing for people, right? So you got to play that reel out for a second. When you're like, I want to hit 100K months. Why do you want to hit 100K months? How come? Because I promise you, you want 100K months, but yet you haven't done the work to do it because you don't actually fucking care about the 100K months. It's what it represents that you care about. And so we have to actually shift the focus off of that, right? Like, track the money, because if you're not paying attention to the money, then you're not going to fucking pay attention to the money. And it's like, whatever you don't pay attention to is never going to get anywhere, right? Whatever you put your focus on will grow. So of course, track the money, pay attention to the money. But don't mix it up or confuse it with, I want to be famous because I'm just prideful. I want 100K months because I just care about money. It's not what it is. If it was, what are you gonna do? Take the money and leave it in savings and never touch it? Like, what does the money represent? What is the lifestyle? What is the freedom? What is the healing? What is the gift that you're bringing to the world? What do you feel called to do? What lights you the fuck up, right? It's about that. And it's about recognizing that the story that, if I do really well and if I have this really amazing life that I'm taking away from someone else. I used to believe if I had a nice car, I was literally contributing to starving children in Africa. That was my story. So insane. It has nothing to do with the greedy ass men and women that are in power that are using innocence in a tug of war. It has to do with how much money I have and what kind of car I make, right? Like, it doesn't make any sense. But money will give you fame, which gives you influence. Give you power, which gives you ability to create and transform, and freedom to actually free up time for you to be the things that you feel called to be. I don't know what the fuck could be more humble than that, right? So we get to play that reel out a little bit more. Half of my friends fell off, but I gained others. You will outgrow the box. You will no longer fit in with people that you used to fit in with. And there's hundreds of thousands of us on the other side just waiting for your ass to get here so you can be in life with us too, because we all love more friends and more connection, right? This is why I do the stuff I do. I've literally created an entire business around just being with other women who are doing this journey, which is fucking awesome. We get to meet up in real life and like celebrate and travel the world together. Bali, Maui, right? Like, it's a good life. Hell yes. Yep, they will fuck it up and I will have to rescue them. Right? It's a convenient story. It's definitely one of my biggest stories. My biggest pattern is they'll take me down with them. I'm gonna have to rescue everybody. I can't have any more people in my life because then I'm gonna have to rescue them too. Right? Like, oh, so I'm just like, oh, I get to chuckle every time it pops up. Like, okay, there you are. Go play now. I'm gonna show up and be who I choose to be. Right? So, it's about remembering they're getting the result that they want. And if they wanted something else, they would be actively pursuing it just like you fucking did. Just like you did, because everything that's available for you is also available for them, and they can opt into it when they decide they're ready to opt into it. And there is no shortage of abundance for them. No shortage of abundance. Everything they need is there available for them when they start opting into it. And people start at different levels. Yeah, and sure, maybe you're starting at a place where when you're stepping forward, it's actually about, you know, using your savings to invest in something. And maybe for them, it's like they have fucked up back and knees and they can't even start getting their first workout in because it's so painful. But that's their soul's journey, and they still get to step in, and it still feels just as hard for you to invest at this level as it feels for them to invest at this level. And whatever the work is, and there's no judgment about that. That's the soul's journey, and it's not your fucking place to interrupt that soul journey, right? And you get to remember that. It actually does not provide healing whatsoever for you to rescue someone else and not allow them to go through the journey, the same journey that you went through that got you fucking seasoned and got you all the way here where you're listening to this kind of shit and opting into this kind of shit. Give them the same chance, the same opportunity that your soul got, right? If someone came along and kept rescuing you, you would not be here. Getting good with attention and taking intuitive action rather than getting paralyzed is where my big growth edge is right now. This is so good. That is so exciting, right? The more attention you can handle, the more epic results you get. That's just the way the cookie crumbles, right? Like, my favorite quote is the one, I don't know who said it. I don't remember where I read it. But life is rigged for the bold. And now, like, where I'm at, and even like headed to seven figures, when the decisions I have to make and the tension that I feel like when I step into things, is like, that's why nobody does this. That's why so few people hit $1 million entrepreneur businesses. Like, okay, I thought the same thing when I hit six figures. Like, oh, that's why nobody does this. That's why people aren't successful. They're not willing to feel what I feel right now and learn and season themselves into a position of faith. They want to control everything. They want to feel safe through control. A quote I love: if you're not living on the edge, you're taking up too much space. Yeah. That's really funny. I've heard that 100 times, but it never really registered. I don't know if I like it though. I don't like people feeling like they're not allowed to take up space. I think my quote would be like, if you're not living on the edge, then you're fucking bored. And I know you're bored. So I know you want to know better. So here's my fucking program to come learn how to not be so fucking bored. I think that's what I would say. Oh, that one just made me laugh. So buy my shit. That's what I would say. Oh, that's funny. And just trusting the message to come through me by setting the intention I'm available to deliver the message. And you'll fuck it up and it won't matter. It won't fucking matter at all, and nobody else will notice. And everybody, there's so many times I've done it, I was like, oh wow, that just really wasn't good at all. And then like people be like, oh my God, that transformed my life. That helped me so much. And I'm like, oh fucking every time. I don't know why I ever judge it. Like, I needed to assess what the message was. Like, I don't need to assess it. Sometimes the message feels like super confusing or weird and like high level and nobody's gonna get it. Sometimes it feels like super basic and low level and I'm like, oh, I don't wanna teach that. That's super basic. And sometimes I just feel excited about the message, but it doesn't matter. The message is the message, right? If the song is inside of you, let the shit out. The world needs your song. Fuck yes. Oh my God, yes. This is why I've been listening to these, like, all these power songs. Like, I think one of the lyrics is, I just thought of one, but I'm not going to share that one. It's like, how does it go? Hold on. It's so good. Oh. It's like, I work till I'm dead and then I do it all again. I kill cause I'm hungry. I kill cause I'm hungry. And it's like this really like loud, powerful song, right? And like for me, it's like, that might sound violent, but for me, it's like kill, meaning like just crushing it. Just like standing in that tension and allowing myself to soak up that tension and that energy and just like staying there, stepping and stepping and stepping. And like hunger is like the thing that I feel, this fire and this passion to help serve women out there and help them to see their worth and get to the next level. It's like songs like that, like really they do. They really like, oh, they light me up. And it's like my own version of what resonates with me on what killing is and what being hungry is. Right? I love it. We so are the fucking same. Right? Right? When you start understanding this, so you like look at like, so maybe like there's people that might be ahead of me financially, right? So like where my business at is like $500,000. So like if that's aspirational to you though, if that's like, oh my God, I don't even know how I would get there. I remember when I felt that way. That wasn't very long ago at all, but I remember when I felt that way, right? And so what you need to recognize is we literally are the fucking same. There's nothing different about me. I'm just allowing myself to be me and allowing myself to stand in the fucking tension and allowing myself to receive things. I'm questioning things like, how much can I receive? How much love can I receive? Like I just allow myself to keep expanding in those places and pulling in resources that keep me on track with that. Because otherwise, when I'm left to my own devices, I just go all off. I just start playing the victim and being bitchy and cranky, and I start controlling things. That's just what I do when I'm left to my own devices, right? So I work really hard. Like, I stand in the fucking tension, right? Like, what I invest with my mentor is $6,000 a month. That, trust me, for 3 months, that was a lot of fucking tension. I was struggling, man. That shit was uncomfortable. And I was like, oh, I forgot what this feels like. This is so hard. What? It was like so much tension, right? Then I worked through those patterns of being sick and all that bullshit. Like, oh, I just up-leveled and now I'm sick. And this is what always happens. And poor me. I went through all of that stuff. And that was just like 6 months ago, right? So that's just what it looks like. You allow yourself to be in the tension. And if you're like, we're the exact fucking same. The exact same. Same shit that happened when we were kids. Different variations. Same emotions. Same fucking feelings. Same fucking fears. It feels the same to me that it does to you to stand in that tension. I just decided to pull in resource and support to help me do it, and allowed myself to stand in the tension and get on the other side of that and learn the lesson, and just kept fucking doing that because it works. We really are the same, and you are absolutely going to make it, and this is going to happen for you, and you really do get to have the life that you want to have, and everything that's going on in your life is being perfectly hand-picked and designed for you to be able to step into it and be seasoned and have all the things you want on the other side. It's designed for your growth and for your reward, and all that ever needed to happen was you needed to allow it and to receive it and to start stepping into the expansion, which does feel like tension in the beginning. But if you can allow yourself to do that, you get to have all the rewards on the other side, period. That made me cry. I do want to help heal the world, shifting my mindset today. Yes. Yes. Christy, you are being called to be fame, right? To live in fame, for your name to be known, for you to be somebody where people can look up to and resonate with you and be called to more through your voice and through your story. Otherwise, you wouldn't have that longing. Not everybody has that longing. They just don't, right? That wasn't even part of my longing, but I had a longing for power, and that comes with it, right? So like, even though it didn't resonate with me to be like, I want to be famous, like inside I had a pattern against that. It was the same thing. I wanted fame. I just didn't recognize it because what I really wanted was power. So I had the power to fight injustice and to help heal people I love because there was so much injustice when I was a kid, right? Same thing. Yes. By the way, crying is so fucking good. Please allow yourself to cry. Let yourself cry. It's just, imagine living your whole, I don't know if I already said this, I say it a lot. Imagine your whole life like you weren't allowed to laugh. Like every time you laughed, it was bad, or someone told you not to, or you tried to hide it every time you laughed. Could you imagine what you'd feel like? It's the same thing. Why are we not crying? Fucking cry. Money is not the point. It's serving and how I feel when I can serve at optimal level. So now I'm available for all the money and all the freedom. And money gets you ability to be able to reach and serve more people, right? So it's like, money is just a resource. It's just a thing. It's just an exchange of energy. That's it, right? Money is the thing that you'll be able to hand over to put your ass in the space of tension so that you're taking in step one and you're allowing yourself to see what's on step two, three, and four. It's fucking perfect. Whew, it's a good journey. It's a good life. Oh my gosh, I can't wait till we're all traveling the world together. Let's do this, ladies, right? I do believe I'm going to have a retreat in Florida. Basically, when I get there, anyone on here, you've got to make it to one of my Bali retreats. Fuck, are they awesome. Anyone who's been to my Bali retreats, make sure you do a little post in here. They're just so amazing. We're just together in a home. We have private chefs, and we are in the vibration of Bali. Maui is so epic, too. It's a different energy. It's so powerful. I absolutely love it. And then even the local retreats, we do them stateside. I'm not going to scroll off on this too much, but we do it stateside, and it's a different energy. It's more like it's a this energy, right? Like step, 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 step. The one in Bali is kind of like, you are so free to be anything you truly fucking are. And it's such an air and an energy of non-judgment and expansion. It's so powerful. And Maui is more like a healing, like a deep healing energy. It's like deeply transformational and healing. There's such different energies, which is why I choose to do different retreats at different places. It's very thought out. I needed to hear that, not a rescuer. It's a complex, hero complex, right? And don't forget, when you're doing that, when you're telling yourself you have to rescue people, it's a procrastination pattern, so you don't have to do the shit we're talking about here. That allow, like, the action you take that requires you to be comfortable in the tension. Of course we're gonna avoid that. We don't wanna feel the tension, so we avoid that and we shift it on other people. So it's just another way to procrastinate. Took the step to be in financial tension, but I got stuck in moving ahead in the fear of the tension. That's what we do. We don't do it perfectly. We don't do it gracefully. We get to just brush ourselves off and keep fucking going. I get to do it again with new intention. Hell yes. To no longer fear, but to dig in deep and call others in financials. hell yes. We're never going to do it perfectly. You're going to be like, hell yes, I'm doing this. And you step in, and then 2 weeks later, you're like, what the fuck did I do? I made the wrong decision. That's why we call it the bipolar journey, right? It's like, you're up, you're down, you're up, you're down, you're up, you're down, you're in, you're out. Like, that's what it is. And then you learn, like, the spaces in between where you're freaking out if you made the right decision or you're starting to get scared, they get smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller until you're at the point where, like, that thought comes in and it's just not even a thing. Like, it doesn't even fucking matter, right? And you're just like, yeah, 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 I know what that is. This is just a shit storm right before all the amazing things happen. Tracy, Bali retreat, life-changing. Tracy was with us. I just got such insight. My high-paying client decided to cancel the rest of the program because she doesn't have the money. Exactly the day that I decided I was tired and didn't want to do anything and watch TV for hours, the universe messaged, do you want it or not? Because it seems like you don't, so I'm going to kick your ass. God will never override your free will. Never. This is why people don't understand, like, why does journaling matter? Why does meditation matter? This is what I'm fucking talking about. Every single time it happens, I start to tell myself the story that, like, it's hard and I can't, and, like, my business just goes like, and then whenever I'm tuned in and I'm doing the work and I'm focusing and I'm, this is getting better, my business is growing, I'm healing more people, I love showing up, it always gives me energy, and it starts expanding and expanding and expanding. This is a perfect example, right? Like, this was an expansive thing for me to be like, I'm just gonna run a free fucking group just for anybody who wants to come join, and I'll get more touch points with new play. And it was like, yeah. So as far as, like, business strategy, I'll get email opt-ins and I'll get to connect with new people that hopefully will join with us later. But as an energetic, which is the most important part, it creates massive expansion, right? Because now I'm just stepping into truly serving and showing up, and people will get what they get from it, and it's a great foundation for them to step into the next thing. And I don't fucking care what that is. Yes, I would love people to come work with us, but I don't fucking care, as long as they're actually taking action in their life to get their healing out in the world, because that is my purpose. So I believe if I'm supporting people to step out and own their worth and own their greatness, I will be well taken care of, because life supports life. Right, so as I'm showing and I'm supporting life, I will be supported. So I don't care if this was, one of my 30K offers that I'm offering you, my $30,000 program, or if it's just a free program, I'm showing up the fucking same, because my belief is that I'm taken care of when I support life, right? Does that make sense? So I got an intuitive prompt for this, so I showed up. So yes, hell yes on that, right? And way to own that, because that takes a lot, Lilia. It takes a lot, instead of, because you could have chose the story like, see, that's why I didn't even want to try, because it's not even going to work, instead of being like, I just created that shit. I just energetically created that shit. Everything in your life is a product of your thoughts. I'm coming to Bali. I'm making it happen. Oh my God, that'd be so fucking awesome. I'm going to Bali with you, Mandy. I think next time we're going to be able to have like 30 people, which is going to be really awesome. This time it was a lot smaller group, bipolar journey. Isn't it the perfect explanation? Can't wait for the storm to happen, sitting my ass down to put my program in place. Not just a concept, not just an outline, but truly detailed with intention. Thanks for this extortion. Okay, so also, even maybe you don't have to worry about all the details, but you can actually fucking get it done. So you feel like, yes, that's my program. And like you sort of internally, you feel that switch where it's like, yes, this is my program. And then you fucking offer it. That's like a 10x, right? So like getting it done in detail is awesome. Getting it done in detail enough that you feel like you're clear what the program is, and then making a fucking offer, that's 10x, right? Okay, let me just check if there's anything else I really want to get to you guys today, because I know we're over on time. You earn success by choosing fear over and over. By choosing the tension over and over, that is the way you earn success. So when you hear successful people being like, you earn the place of getting here, that's what they're talking about. All the moments that they felt that tension that other people are unwilling to do. The tough decisions they made, the seasoning they went through, the allowing themselves to see their own shit and work through it. Those are all the ways that you earn, right? So you earn it by choosing fear over and over. Fear is a compass guiding you where to go. You've heard that 1,000 times, right? Maybe it makes a little more sense now. Okay, I'm gonna leave you guys with this. 1, trust your intuition. Trusting your intuition. Just trusting your intuition. When it's a hell yes, you say fucking hell yes. Don't say hell yes, but I don't know about step 2, 3, 4. No, just fucking hell yes, right? 2, doubt your fears. So the validity of your fears. When a fear creeps in, we never make a decision based on fear, right? So start doubting your fears and trusting your intuition, right? Anticipate good things happening. Pranoia. right? Anticipate good things happen. Like today, what fucking amazing shit's going to happen today? What blessings are going to come down raining from heaven on you? What expansion is going to happen? What are you going to receive today? There's going to be something wonderful and incredible happening for you today. I literally have a little thing on my wall. When I open my eyes, there it is. It's like, I'm expecting amazing, incredible fucking things to happen today, right? In whatever beautiful way it says it. Risk being seen so you can get the rewards on the other side, right? Risk being seen. Practice your boundaries. Actually practicing your boundaries, right? We might get more into that tomorrow, right? Trust your intuition, doubt your fears, anticipate good fucking things happen, risk being seen, and practice your boundaries. Raja, yeah, Pranoya. Expecting wonderful fucking things to happen, and lo and behold, fucking wonderful things happen. It's really incredible how that works. Expect bad things to happen, and lo and behold, a bunch of bad shit happens. That's just how it works. I don't care if it sounds like fluff. It's real. And all of the universe fucking lines backs that up. You never get it wrong and never get it done. Everything is always working out and it's time to allow and coast. Yes, Diana, I love that. You never get it wrong and never get it done. That is really good. I've never heard that. I love that. I may use that one. I like it a lot. Okay, guys. So, what do I want to know now? All right, what was your biggest aha from today? Just like pop the first thing. Don't try to say something fancy. Just the first thing that comes to mind, pop it in the comments. I want to see the biggest ahas from today. And if there's something you're going to fucking take action on today, let me know what that is. Is it real? You get what you think about whether you want it or not. So pay attention to what you feel. It is so true. You get what you think about whether you want it or not. That was literally the first slides of one of my retreats. Whether you want it or not, you're going to fucking manifest the shit that you're consistently thinking about. That's a really good one. What else? What are the other ahas that we have going on today? Or action that you're going to fucking take today and back yourself up today. It takes courage to get clarity. Yes. Belief, action, deciding. So really, for most people, it'll resonate with belief, deciding, action. But deciding and action is the same fucking thing. If it's actually deciding, then it looks like action. Create the need so the universe can fill it. Yes! That was one of my biggest breakthroughs too. That's such a huge one, Christina. I'm so glad you get that one. It's so big. I wasn't sure if I was going to teach that right. Create the need, live in the tension, positive thoughts always. Nailed it! Stand in the tension, create the need. Yes, so many. Oh my God! Yay! I was worried I wasn't going to be able to, like, how do you describe something like that? I've never tried, so. Get busy getting it done, putting my program down in words and internalizing it. It's time. This is my next step I've been asking for. And then share it with the world, Jackie. I think I have to rescue everyone, so that's why I'm not seen. Yeah. So you used to think that you had to rescue everyone. Now you recognize that that's some arrogant bullshit and you're just messing with space between them and God, and we're just not going to do that shit anymore. Hashtag getting out of the fucking pot. Oh my God. What you just didn't realize, girlfriend, is that that pot is really fucking big. And so you thought it was a little pot. And now today you woke up and you realize it's a really fucking big pot that just expands the entire world. It's like the world is your pot. I'm literally going to find a way to make the world, the globe, with a little bonsai tree sticking out for you. Action. Know my numbers. Yes. What you focus on expands, including the numbers. Wrote my next program and post about it. Write it. Yes. Oh, fake training. We got some cool person on here. I'm making a new beautiful opt-in that is a video. People are going to my site to get a free book while we published, and I could feel myself shrinking. Done it today. Wait. I'm making a new beautiful opt-in. Hold on. Hi, girls. You all set? That's okay. My daughter and her friend just were sneaking through. I got distracted. Okay, Danielle. I'm making a new beautiful opt-in that is a video. People are going to my site to get a free book we published, and I could feel myself shrinking. Done today. Yes! Isn't it funny how we shrink back right before the expansion? Just so you know, that's what it's supposed to feel like. Life is rigged for the bold. Get that shit up there. Way to go. Yeah, create the need. I've seen that happen over and over, right? Totally tracking. Live in the tension, grew, and then ready to go forward. Then stuck in the fear, ready to up-level. That's just the way it is. Fuck yes. Sit in the tension, create the need, and not that all is rigged in your favor. Trust the brilliance of the universe.
Or you could try to be the CEO of the universe and let us all fucking know how that goes for you. Hashtag stay in my own lane. Okay, yes, this is mine too. I feel like I need to tattoo that on my arm. Like, I'm going to tattoo my husband's face with words coming out that says, get in your own lane. He would love that shit. Everything that's available to me is available to others. Yes, remember that when that old feeling of I have to rescue them comes up, or you find yourself veering away from relationships or not engaging in groups or not being present with other people because you're worried that they're going to take you down with them. That was so big for me. I get myself in trouble and I always get what I need. Never made the connection before. I get myself in trouble and I always get what I need. Never made the connection before. I'm not sure what that one means. I always get what I need. I understand. How loved am I willing to allow myself to be? Right? This one still, like, even when I said that one to you guys, that one still got to me a little bit. I still noticed myself being a little bit teary when I said it. How loved. My name as a child was, my name is Mandy as a child. As a child, I definitely felt unloved. Like, it was a pretty traumatic childhood. And my name means lovable. Mandy actually means lovable. And that's always meant so much to me. Like, we don't allow ourselves to feel lovable, but you are so fucking lovable. Like, epically worldwide lovable. Create the need, be willing to stand in the tension, break the block that we only get what we create. Yeah, and remember, the tension isn't like a tension that's like you have to feel bad in order to get somewhere good. It's just tension because it's unfamiliar. So it's just the nervous, low-levelest part of us trying to keep us safe, right? So remember that. It's not actually like, it just feels like tension because it's unfamiliar. It's not actually bad. Do step one, the rest will come. Trust is everything. Hell yes. F the how. Oh God, that was such a struggle for me. The how, like, was just, and it's, I'm not gonna lie, it's still like, when I was scaling from 500,000 to 1,000,000, it's like, oh, obviously it just needs a bunch of funnel and technical stuff. And it was still like, I still shifted over to how and had to get knocked in the head like 3 times. Like, that's not it. Like, that's not the fucking thing. Like, yeah, learn that on the side, but that's not the thing. It's not the main thing. And if you shift over to that, everything's gonna start slowing down. And it's so true, right? The thing that for me is actually what I fucking care about and getting my gift to the world so I can heal women and keeping that creative imagination going on what I'm creating and then showing up my intuitive prompts and actually making it happen, just like this training, right? Okay, that is the end of this training. You guys had some epic ahas. As always, if something comes to mind that you're gonna take action, post it in the comments. Like, come back. If you took action from yesterday, post it in the comments. If you have any questions, post in the comments, and then feel free to tag any of your sisters or brothers that you feel like will be supported by this message, because my whole intention is to just fucking get this message out there to heal as many people as we can. Life supports life, so we know that we're all taken care of as we spread the healing and the love, right? Okay, guys, I love you so much. Have a fantastic day, and then post anything that comes up for you guys. I will see you tomorrow. You're so welcome, Christy. Love you guys. Love hot shower. I'll wait for that. Because I love it. All right, bye, guys.